हरे कृष्णा, टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्ट रीडिंग द श्रीमद् भागवतम इंट्रोडक्शन. स्टार्ट विद द प्रेयर्स. ओम अज्ञातिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानांजनाशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति सापदान्तिकं. वन्देहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवां च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथं नितं तंसजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादां सहगण ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितां च. नम ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामीति नामिने. नमस्ते सारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे. जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री वसति गौर भक्ति वृंद. हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे. यस, द इंट्रोडक्शन आई विल स्टार्ट रीडिंग. द कंसेप्शन ऑफ गॉड एंड द कंसेप्शन ऑफ अब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ आर नॉट ऑन द सेम लेवल. The Srimad Bhagavatam hits on the target of the absolute truth. The conception of God indicates the controller, whereas the conception of the absolute truth indicates the Samman Bonam, or the ultimate source of all energies. There is no difference of opinions about the personal feature of God as the controller, because a controller cannot be impersonal. Of course, modern government, especially democratic government, is impersonal to some extent, but ultimately the chief executive head is a person, and the impersonal feature of government is subordinate to the personal feature. So without a doubt, whenever we refer to control over others, we must admit the existence of a personal feature, because there are different controllers for different managerial positions. There may be many small gods. According to the Bhagavad Gita, any controller who has some specific extraordinary power is called a vibhutimat sattva, or controller empowered by the Lord. There are many vibhutimat sattvas, controllers or gods with various specific powers, but the absolute truth is one without a second. This Srimad Bhagavatam designates the absolute truth or the Samman Bonam as the Param Satyam. So in this particular paragraph, we can summarize the conception of God and the conception of absolute truth are not on the same. Here the God, anybody can be God if he has some controlling power, which we can see in the 33 crores of demigods also, they are gods. And even in the modern diplomacy, they say God. Different have different opinions. You can be God, I can be, anybody can be God. But the absolute truth, that cannot be. And that also not impersonal, that is personal. Example is given, the democratic government is impersonal feature, but the absolute truth is also a person, is also a personal feature. So this is the conclusion of this particular. It's Param Satyam and Samman Bonam. Hare Krishna, please read the second paragraph.
The author of Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Vyasadeva, first offers his respectful obeisances unto Param Satya, Absolute Truth. And the Param Satyam is the ultimate source of all energy. Param Satyam is the Supreme Person. The gods or controllers are undoubtedly persons, but the Param Satyam from whom the God derives power of control is the Supreme Person. The word Ishvara controller conveys the import of God. The supreme person is called Parameshwara or the supreme Ishvara. The supreme person or Parameshwara is the supreme conscious personality, and because he does not derive any power from any source, he is supremely independent. In the Vedic literature, Brahma is described as the supreme god or the head of all other gods like Indra, Chandra, Varuna. But Srimad Bhagavatam confirms that Brahma is not independent as far as his power and knowledge are concerned. He received knowledge in the form of Vedas from the supreme person who resides within the heart of every living entity. The supreme personality knows everything directly and indirectly. Individual infinitesimal person who are part and parcel of supreme personality may know directly or indirectly everything about their body or external features, but the supreme personality knows everything about his external and internal features. So in the beginning, Srila Vyasadeva offers respect to Param Satyam. The Param Satyam is the controller. Sometimes the word Ishvara or God is used, but Ishvara or God is not the supreme controller. He has some qualities, but Krishna is the Param Satyam, supreme controller, and even very high controllers, right? Like Brahmaji receives some power of opulence from Krishna, and the infinitesimal jiva may know something about their body, but they are not supreme control. Only Krishna is Parameshwara.
Hare Krishna. Now, are you able to hear me, Prabhu?
Yes, yes.
Okay. The words Janmadi Asse suggest that the source of all production, maintenance, and destruction is the same supreme conscious person. Even in our present experience, we can know that nothing is generated from inert matter, but inert matter can be generated from the living entity. For instance, by contact with the living entity, the material body develops into a working machine. Men with a poor fund of knowledge mistakes the bodily machinery to be the living being. But the fact is that the living being is the basis of the bodily machine. The bodily machine is useless as soon as the living spark is away from it. Similarly, the original source of all material energy is the Supreme Person. This fact is expressed in all the Vedic literatures, and all the exponents of spiritual science have accepted this truth. The living force is called Brahman, and one of the greatest Acharya's teachers, namely Sri Pada Sankaracharya, has preached that the Brahman is substance, whereas the cosmic world is category. The original source of all energies is the living force, and he is logically accepted as the supreme person. He is therefore conscious of everything, past, present, and future, and also each and every corner of his maintenance, manifestation, both material and spiritual. An imperfect living being does not even know what is happening within his own personal body. He eats his food but does not know how this food is transformed into energy or how it sustains his body. When a living being is perfect, he is aware of everything that happens. And since the Supreme Person is all perfect, it is quite natural that he knows everything in all detail. Consequently, the perfect personality is addressed in the Srimad Bhagavatam as Vasudeva, or one who lives everywhere in full consciousness and in full possession of his complete energy. All of this is clearly explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam, and the reader has ample opportunity to study this critically. So this is very amazing statements, Prabhupada, introduction. This is the first sloka, Janmadiyasayataha. How the production, maintenance and destruction is all done by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Absolute Truth. Because everything is created by him, he knows everything in details. As the living entity, cause of the growth of the material body. Similarly, the material and spiritual everything is caused by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So this is accepted by Sripada Sankaracharya also. How the Brahman is substantial to the personal Brahman. And he is the source of all material and spiritual worlds. And he knows each and every corner of the his own creation. That's why it's called as Vasudeva. He knows, that means he who lives everywhere in full consciousness and full possession. So this is given in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So we can read this study and we can understand this. Hare Krishna. You want to add anything or let us continue the next paragraph?
I will continue.
Okay, please read next paragraph.
In the modern age, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu preached the Srimad Bhagavatam by practically demonstrating it is easier to penetrate into the topics of the Srimad Bhagavatam through the medium of Chaitanya's causeless mercy. Therefore, a short sketch of his life and precept is inserted herein to help the reader understand the real merit of Srimad Bhagavatam. It is imperative that one learns the Srimad Bhagavatam from the person Bhagavatam. The person Bhagavatam is one whose very life is Srimad Bhagavatam in practice. Since Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the absolute personality of Godhead, he is both Bhagwan and Bhagavatam in person and in sound. Therefore, his process of approaching the Srimad Bhagavatam is practical for all people of the world. It is his wish that Srimad Bhagavatam be preached in every nook and corner of the world by those who happen to take their birth in India. So this is a very interesting point, that by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, we will be able to get the real essence of Srimad Bhagavatam, because he is Bhagwan plus he is Bhagavatam. He is person Bhagavat as a pure devotee, and he is Supreme Personality of Godhead. So though in both the way, by his mercy and by his will, he wants this message to be preached all over India.
Very nice. Hare Krishna. So, next paragraph. The Srimad Bhagavatam is the science of Krishna, the absolute personality of Godhead, of whom we have preliminary information from the text of the Bhagavad Gita. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said that anyone, regardless of what he is, who is well versed in the science of Krishna, that means Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita, can become an authorized preacher or preceptor in the science of Krishna. There is a need for the science of Krishna in human society, for the good of all suffering humanity of the world. And we simply request the leaders of all nations to pick up the science of Krishna for their own good, for the good of society, and for the good of all the world's people. So, in these two paragraphs, we understand the absolute personality of Godhead, we can know his knowledge from Srimad Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. So prior to Srimad Bhagavatam, preliminary knowledge from the Bhagavad Gita. So these both are called as signs of Krishna. So whoever knows these signs of Krishna, he can become an authorized preacher. And there's a need also in a human society for the preachers or preceptors in the science of Krishna. Because the whole world is suffering because want of this knowledge. So all of leaders, nations and society all should take of this Krishna book, Krishna knowledge, science of Krishna, Krishna consciousness for all the good. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
A short sketch of the life and teachings of Lord Chaitanya, the preacher of Srimad Bhagavatam. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the great apostle of love of God and the father of congregational chanting of the holy name of the Lord, adventured himself at Sridharmayapur at quarter in the city of Navadvip in Bengal on the Falgun Purnima evening in the year 1407. The corresponding to the February 1486 by the Christian calendar. His father, Sri Jagannath Mishra, a learned Brahmana from the district of Shillet, came to Navadvip as a student because at the time Navadvip was considered to be the center of education and culture. He domiciled on the bank of Ganges after marrying Srimati Sachi Devi, a daughter of Srila Nilambar Chakravarti, the great learned scholar of Navadvip. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhuji adventured in Sridham Mayapur in the 1486, February 1486, and his father was staying in Shillet, and then he came to Navadvip since Navadvip were considered the place of culture and education, and his mother Sachi, then he married Srimati Sachi Devi, the daughter of Nilambar Chakravarti, who became the mother of Lord Chaitanya.
Jaho, so we'll be hearing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life and precepts so that we can understand this Srimad Bhagavatam. So let us continue the next paragraph. So Jagannath Mishra had a number of daughters by his wife. Srimati Sachi Devi, and most of them expired at an early age. So what happened is this Jagannath Mishra and Sachi Mata, they got married, and before the marriage before this birth of our Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there are many daughters. They have expired early age. Correct, no bro?
Correct.
So then later two surviving sons, Sri Vishwarupa and Vishwambara, become at last the object of their parental affection. The 10th and youngest son, who was named Vishwambara. 9th and youngest son, 10th. 10th son later became known as Nimai Pandit, and then after accepting the renounced order of life, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So he was, in this family, he was the 10th member, Before
the Jagannath Mishra had two sons, Vishwarup and Vishwambar.
So before that, there are daughters also. They have left their bodies. This means the 10th youngest son means he's the last one, our Vishwambar. So 10th, he means 9th might be Vishwarup.
9th
is Vishwarup. Before that, 8 daughters are left their bodies in the early age. The 10th son. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu exhibited his transcendental activities for 48 years and then disappeared from the mortal world in the year of 1455 Shekaba at Puri. So He lived here in 48 years in the earthly planet and exhibited all the activities, pastimes and leela and disappeared. 1455 means after 48 years. Then what will be the our Christian calendar? 1486 plus 48. How much it is?
Fifteen thirty-four.
He left his world. That's why we say 500 years back, everything happened. Yeah. Roji, can you continue reading the next paragraph?
Jagannath Mishra had a number of.
That is over.
For his first 20 years, he remained at Navadvip as a student and householder. His first wife was Srimati Lakshmi Priya, who died at an early age when Lord was away from home. When he returned from East Bengal, he was requested by his mother to accept a second wife, and he agreed. His second wife was Srimati Vishnu Priya Devi, who bore the separation of the Lord about her life because the Lord took sannyas at the age of 24 when Srimati Vishnu Priya was barely 16 years old. So, after taking sannyas, the Lord made his headquarters at Jagannath Puri due to the request of his mother Sachi Devi. The Lord remained for 24 years at Puri. For 6 years at this time, he traveled continuously all over India preaching Srimad Bhagavatam. So for 24 years, at first 24 years, Lord stayed at Puri and with his first wife Lakshmi Priya.
Stayed where?
In Navadvip. For the first 24 years, Lord stayed at his hometown Navadvip, and he was married to his first wife Lakshmi Priya. And then, when she expired, then again at on the request of his mother, married to Vishnu Priya. And then later, at the age of 24, he took sannyas and then made his on the request of his mother made the Jagannath Puri the headquarters, and he preached the message. For 6 years, he traveled and preached the message of Bhagavatam, especially during the South India.
So, he went for South India 6 years, South India Yatra. So, that means how many years he stayed in Puri?
So, he stayed for...
So, 24 minus 6.
Yes, 24 minus 6. That is 8. That is 18 years.
So, 18 years he stayed in Jagannath Puri.
18 years Mahaprabhu performed first time in Jagannath.
Then 6 years in South India and 24 years in Navadvip. So that's how 24 plus 24?
48.
48 is yes, correct. So all list is coming. Yes, next paragraph. Let me continue. So Lord Chaitanya not only preached the Srimad Bhagavatam, but propagated the teachings of Bhagavad Gita as well. In the most practical way, in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Sri Krishna is depicted as the absolute personality of Godhead, and his lost teaching in that great book of transcendental knowledge instructs that one should give up all the modes of religious activities and accept him, Lord Sri Krishna, as the only worshipable Lord. The Lord then assured that all his devotees would be protected from all sorts of sinful acts, and that for them there would be no cause for anxiety. So I remember in this sloka, it would be 18.66, that Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mam Ekam Saranam Vrajaham Tam Sarva Papakam Mokshe Swami Mahasachah. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not only teaching Bhagavatam, he is also teaching the propagating the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. So these both called signs of Krishna, Krishna Katha. We hear that Krishna Katha, two Krishna Kathas, one is the kathas told by Krishna, that is Bhagavad Gita, and about Krishna, that is Bhagavatam. So those both are propagated in our preaching mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So that's how he is is teaching and is training the book. How he is taking, making that everyone should surrender to Krishna and worship only Krishna, then all his sinful reactions will be taken care. Yes, please continue the next paragraph.
Unfortunately, despite Lord Krishna's direct order and the teaching of the Bhagavad Gita, the less intelligent people misunderstand him to be nothing but a great historical personality, and thus they cannot accept him as the original personality of Godhead. Such men with poor fund of knowledge are misled by many non-devotees. Thus, the teaching of the Bhagavad Gita were interpreted even by great scholars. After the disappearance of Lord Krishna, there were hundreds of commentaries on the Bhagavad Gita, but by many erudite scholars, and almost even one of them was motivated by self. Every one of them was motivated by self-interest. So Sri Krishna has given such a sublime teaching, but due to poor fund of knowledge, people are very much misled by other non-devotees, and they are not able to take the pure essence directly. Even the great scholars, they take some their motive, like Dr. Radhakrishnan has written the commentary on Bhagavad Gita, but he has his own political motive. And they the core essence of devotion and bhakti towards Krishna is missing.
That's amazing. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the self same Lord Sri Krishna. This time, however, he appeared as a great devotee of the Lord in order to preach to the people in general, as well as to religionists and philosophers. About the transcendental position of Sri Krishna, the primeval Lord and the cause of all causes. The essence of his preaching is that Lord Sri Krishna, who appeared at Vrajabhumi, that is Vrindavan, as the son of the king of Vraja, that is Nanda Maharaj, is the supreme personality of Godhead and is therefore worshipable by all. Vrindavan Dham is non-different from the Lord because the name, fame, form, and place where the Lord manifests himself are all identical with the Lord as absolute knowledge. Therefore, Vrindavan Dham is as worshipable as Lord. The highest form transcendental worship of the Lord was exhibited by the damsels of Vrajabhumi in the form of pure affection for the Lord. And Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommends this process as the most excellent mode of worship. He accepts the Srimad Bhagavat Purana as a spotless literature for understanding the Lord, and he preaches that the ultimate goal of life for all human beings is to attain the stage of prema, or love of God. So, although Sri Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, appeared in this planet Earth 5,000 years back, and he given this knowledge of surrendering to him and perform the devotion service, but many misinterpretations because of misguided and because of less intelligence, they could not understand because they are not devotees. They are selfish. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. He is non-different from Krishna. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead. But this time he appeared. The same Lord Sri Krishna appeared in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to preach in people in general. What is his teaching? His teaching not only general people, for religious, philosopher, for everyone. That Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is cause of all causes. And what is the essence of his preaching? His preaching essence is Vrajabhumi, the Vrindavan, is non-different from Krishna. And not only that, his name, form, fame, place, everything is non-different from Krishna. They're identical. They're absolute in knowledge. Therefore, our goal is to worship Vrindavan Dham and his name and form and all pastimes. And how to worship? He showed an example how the Vrajabhumi, the damsels of Vrajabhumi, the gopis, the way they were performed the worship, pure affection for the Lord, there is the topmost worship. And he also accepts Srimad Bhagavata's spotless Purana. So this is his ultimate preaching. and ultimate goal of life of the human beings is to get the stage of prema or love of Godhead. So this is the essence of all preachings. You remember the sloka?
Aradhyo Bhagavan Vrajeshatanaya
Taddhama Vrindavanam
Ramya Kachita Upasana Vrajavadu Vargena Yakalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Prema Pumakumahan Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matamidam
Very nice. So this is the essence of this particular verse only. So, can you read the next paragraph?
Many devotees of Lord Chaitanya like Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur, Srila Lochan Das Thakur, Srila Krishna Das Kavira Goswami, Srila Kavi Karana Purna, Srila Prabodhananda Saraswati, Srila Rupa Goswami, Srila Sanatana Goswami, Srila Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, Srila Jeeva Goswami, Srila Gopal Bhatta Goswami, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, and in the latter age, within 200 years, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti, Srila Baldev Vidya Bhushan, Srila Shyamananda Goswami, Srila Narottam Das Thakur, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur and Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, our spiritual master, and many other great and renowned scholar and devotees of the Lord have prepared voluminous books and literatures on the life and precept of the Lord. Such literatures are all based on Shastras like Veda, Puran, Upanishad, Ramayana, Mahabharata, and other histories and authentic literature approved by the recognized Acharya. They are unique in composition and unrivaled in presentation. They are full of transcendental knowledge. Unfortunately, the people of the world are still ignorant of them. But when these literature are mostly in Sanskrit and Bengali, came to light the world when they are presented before thinking people, India's glory and the message of love will overflood this morbid world, which is vainly searching after peace and prosperity by illusory method not approved by the Acharya in the chain of disciplic succession. So in this paragraph, Srila Prabhupada mentions the name of great Gaudiya Acharyas who have written voluminous book. And these voluminous books are in the lines of the Gama, Agama, both. They are approved by the previous Vedic literatures. And these are very important, and since they are in Sanskrit and Bengali, and now we can see in internet that all these literatures are presented in English language, and many devotees are translating and presenting it in English language. So the glory of by this work of translation, the glory of India's will be propagated all over the world, and people are just looking for miserly pleasure, but the real peace pleasure will be presented through this great work by our Gaudiya Acharyas.
Hare Krishna, all glories
to Gaudiya Acharya.
So the readers of this small description of the life and precepts of Lord Chaitanya will profit much to go through the books of Srila Vrindavana Das Thakur, Sri Chaitanya Bhagavata, and Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. The early life of the Lord is most fascinatingly expressed by the author of Chaitanya Bhagavata. And as far as the teachings are concerned, they are more vividly explained in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Now they are available to the English speaking public in our teachings of Lord Chaitanya. So coming to this Guru Parampara system, then through the our Acharya is confounded Acharya Swami Srila Prabhupada has written all these books, especially the Chaitanya Charitamrita written by Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami in our English language, so we can read the life and precepts of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And here, Vrindavan Das Thakur also written in books which Chaitanya Bhagavat. In this, we can find most of the early Leelas, pastimes of the Lord, but teachings concerned, the teachings are there in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Hare Krishna.
The Lord's early life was recorded by one of his chief devotee and contemporaries, namely Srila Murari Gupta, a medicinal practitioner of that time, and later part of his life of Lord Chaitanya, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was recorded by his private secretary, Sri Damodar Goswami or Swarup Damodar, who was practically a constant companion of the Lord at Puri. These two devotees recorded practically all the incidents of the Lord's activity and later on the book dealing with the Lord, which are above mentioned, are composed on the basis of the Kadacha's notes by Srila Damodar Goswami and Murari Gupta. So I recently went to Radhakund. There is a place where Srila Raghunath Das Goswami and Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami and Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, they used to sit and discuss Chaitanya Charitamrita, because Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami was writing Chaitanya Charitamrita and Raghunath Das Goswami had brought the notes from Jagannath Puri, from Srila Swarup Damodar gave to Raghunath Das Goswami. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami was writing on the basis of the notes given by Srila Swarup Damodar Goswami.
Jai ho. So,
and the early writings were done by Murari Gupta. So Chaitanya Bhagavat contains many early pastimes. Those were written on the basis of notes by Srila Murari.
Very nice. So, the Lord adventured himself on the Falguna Purnima evening of 1407 Shakabda, according to our English calendar, 1486. And it was by the will of the Lord that there was a lunar eclipse on that evening. And during the hours of eclipse, it was the custom of the Hindu public to take bath in the Ganges or any other sacred river and chant the Vedic mantras for purification. When Lord Chaitanya was born during the lunar eclipse, all India was roaring with the holy sound of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. These 16 names of the Lord are mentioned in many Puranas and Upanishads, and they are described as Taraka Brahma Nama. What is that? Taraka Brahma Nama of this age. It is recommended in the Sahasras that offenseless chanting of these holy names of the Lord can deliver a fallen soul from material bondage. There are innumerable names of the Lord, both in India and outside. And all of them are equally good, because all of them indicate the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But because these 16 are especially recommended for this age, people should take advantage of them and follow the path of the great acharyas who attained success by practicing the rules of the sastras, that is revealed scriptures. So very amazingly how the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lifestyle is given here, especially in the Falguna Purnima, which recently celebrated in the month of February, that we call as Gaur Purnima. And Krishna comes by his sweet will. So like similarly, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by his sweet will, he appeared on this particular day of Purnima. It also happened to be the lunar eclipse. In our Hindu custom, that whenever this kind of eclipse happens, we go to the Ganges and take bath and utter some Vedic mantras for purification. So similarly, on the day of evening, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to appear on this particular time. So all the people from India, they are chanting this particular mantra, which is given in the Sastras and Puranas and Upanishads, which is called as Taraka Brahma Nama. What is that? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu adventured himself this sound of holy name also came, that Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So here is given that these names are representing, these names are identical, not represent, is identical with the God. So there is no difference between the different Lord's name and his form and pastime. So when there are many names, either in India and outside of India, you can chant any number of the name, they have perfectly purify us. But especially this particular sixteen syllable of this particular mantra is recommended for this age of Kali. So all of us should take advantage of them and follow the great acharyas who attained that success of Krishna Prem by chanting this 16 and this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, this Taraka Brahma Nama, and strictly follow the rules given in the sastras, the revealed scriptures. Then we'll also attain the same goal which we are anxious. Hare Krishna.
I want to add one point.
Yeah, please do.
There is Taraka Mantra for every yuga.
Okay.
So in Trita Yuga, Ram Nam.
What about Satya Yuga?
Satya Yuga, that Vasudev Gayatri Mantra in the is there, you know? Om Namo Bhagavate Namastubhyam Bhagavate Vasudevaya Dhimahi Pradyumnaya Anirudhaya Nama Shankarshanaya Cha. All the, you see here in the Bhagavatam, many sages have been initiated by that mantra, including Chitraketu Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj and all. So there are Taraka Mantra for, that is a specific mantra for that yuga, and everybody who is qualified to chant that mantra can be delivered. But this mantra, Hare Krishna mantra, is mentioned, and everybody in the Satya Yuga, Trita Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, they knew about this mantra. But the speciality is that in the Kali Yuga, this is the Taraka Mantra and appeared along with the Lord Kali Kale Nama Rupe Krishna Avatar. This is a special benediction for this age. Even though this is mentioned in the scriptures earlier and everybody knew about it.
Very nice point what you are mentioning. But here it's mentioned, many Puranas and Upanishads, these 16 names are mentioned. If you have any reference of which Purana, which Upanishad, can you...
This Hare Krishna Mantra has been mentioned twice in the scriptures.
Which Puranas, which Upanishad?
Kali Santarana Upanishad and another, also one of the Puranas is mentioned. So once it is mentioned by mentioning Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, and another place Hare Krishna is mentioned first.
So this is a homework, Proji. I request you can share through my mail so that we can go through the references where, in which Purana and which Upanishad, these holy names of Taraka Brahma Nama for this particular age of Kali is mentioned. So as many references you'll get, please share us so we can enliven each other and we can share to others. Hare Krishna. So continue reading next paragraph.
The simultaneous occurrence of the Lord's appearance and the lunar eclipse indicates the distinctive mission of the Lord. The mission was to preach the importance of the chanting the holy name of the Lord in this age of Kali. In this present age, quarrel takes place even over a trifle, and therefore the Shastras have recommended for this age a common platform for realization, namely chanting the holy names of the Lord. People can hold meeting to glorify the Lord in their respective language and with melodious song, and if such performance are executed in an offenseless manner, it is certain that participants will gradually attain spiritual perfection without undergoing more religious method. At such meeting, everyone the learned and the foolish, the rich and the poor, the Hindus and the Muslim, the Englishman and the Indian, and the Chandala and the Brahman can all hear the transcendental sound and thus cleanse the dust of material association from the mirror of the heart. To confirm the Lord's mission, all the people of the world will accept the holy name of the Lord as the common platform for universal religion of mankind. In other words, the advent of Lord's name took place along with the advent of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So in this purport, in this paragraph, Srila Prabhupada is mentioning the method for obtaining realization is chanting the names of the Lord. And you see in every religion, religious practice, in Muslim they chant the 99 names of Allah, and in Christian they chant the name in the bead, rosary bead, and in the, you see in Gurudwara this Ek Omkar Satna, you know, and in the Jain also they chant the name of Mahavir and all the Tirthankars. So this chanting is in Bhagavad Gita is mentioned as a greatest yagya. So this chanting is specifically for this age. And without any qualification, Niyamita Smaraneena Kala, without any qualification, without any rules and any fast rules, and anybody can chant and they can attain that. This is a common platform for the universal religion of the mankind. There is a universal religion association where ISKCON is also part of that, and they hold conference every year. Once they had hold a conference in Mayapur, and the theme was that the universal religion common platform, and ISKCON presented that the chanting of the holy name some people can say the common platform of religion can be peace of mind, or somebody can say the common platform of all the religion can be that supreme Lord which we are at. But here Srila Prabhupada specifically mentioned the name of the Lord is a common platform for all the religious practice, all the spiritual practice in all over the world.
Amazing. This particular paragraph I would like to add how Prabhupada is telling you can hold the meetings for glorifying the Lord in their own respective languages, all languages, Telugu, Hindi, English, Gujarati, Marathi, whatever language, and melodiously sing the holy names of the Lord. But you perform this very offenselessly so that you will get the result as quickly as possible. So if you are foolish, no problem, you chant Hare Krishna. If you are learned, no problem, chant Hare Krishna. You are rich, poor, Hindu, Muslim, no problem. Hindi, English, Indian, Chandala, Brahmanas, whomever you are, accept this holy name and cleanse your heart from the dust of material association. Then we will be getting the Krishna.
Since the mind is very flickering in Kali Yuga, so this is like, even they can sing the song. In other yogas, they were very much focused. So mantra meditation, different mantras in the Vedic. But this, now we cannot concentrate much for a long time. So this entertainment form of approaching God is also, we can see in ISKCON. And many youths, if you tell the young boys to come to Kirtan Mela, they will definitely come. But if they tell to chant, come for the Vedic mantra chanting, much of the boys will not come. So this is very much suitable for this Kirtan with mridangas and musical instrument is very suitable for this age.
Jai Ho. When the Lord was in the lap of his mother, he would at once stop crying as soon as the ladies surrounding him chanted the holy names and clapped their hands. This particular incident was observed by the neighbors with awe and veneration. Sometimes the young girls took pleasure in making the Lord cry and then stopping him by chanting the holy name. So from this very childhood, the Lord began to preach the importance of the holy name. In his early age, Lord Sri Chaitanya was known as Nimai. This name was given by his beloved mother. Because the Lord took his birth beneath the Nimba tree in the courtyard of his parental house. So in these two paragraphs also, previously also, there are the reason, appearance on this particular day, it happens a lunar eclipse. So this dictates the mission of the Lord. The mission of the Lord means the day, the evening when the Lord appeared, all the people all over the India chanting this Hare Krishna mantra. And not only that, the slowly growing up, and he was in the lap of his mother Sachi,
Still he's crying. He's crying for what? He's crying for every people to chant Hare Krishna. So we don't chant, then Lord will cry. So when we chant, then Lord will be happy. So the ladies over there, they are making fun. They are making pleasure. Making Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cry, and they are also stopping cry by chanting this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So from this childhood pastimes also Lord started preaching the importance of the holy name. So it's very important for in our life also, taking the seriously the chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. This is the yuga age, the main thing. So we have the main preference for that. So we'll make Lord happy, because Lord is crying. Because you're not chant, then we chant, Lord will be happy. So this Leela is Lord is showing. Another point in this particular paragraph is that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's earlier name was Nimai, because we find in a Vedic system also, the name is given according to the place they were born. Especially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu born and Nimba tree. What is the Nimba tree now called? Neem tree. So the Neem tree, which very, very, very medically very powerful tree and very glorious tree that is also. So under that tree, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth. So that's why his name.
The tree is present in the Yogpeet temple in Maya.
Present is still also, we can visit that. That's great. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, another name is called Nimai. And previously also his name was Vishwambara. Vishwambara. Vishwarupa and Vishwambara, which we read in the previous paragraphs.
That is the official name, and this is Nimai is like the home pet name.
Amazing. So he was where? The Nimba tree and parental house. This tree is there in the parental house, na? That Nilambara Chakravarti. What is Sachi Devi Mata's mother? Sachi is what is the father name?
Nilambara Chakravarti.
So this tree is there in Nilambara Chakravarti?
No, this tree is present in the house of his father.
Whose father? Jagannath Mishra.
Jagannath Mishra's house only. That is there is a house in the Yogpeet. There is a house. Their house is house of Jagannath Mishra and Sachi Mata.
But when the pregnancy happens, they generally go to the parental home, no? So this is mentioned here. Mentioned that courtyard of a parental house. The parental means what?
Parental house. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Okay.
His parental house.
Okay. Nice. Not the Nilambara Chakravarti house.
That is only for Srila Prabhupada's mother went to.
Very nice.
That is another question.
Shall we stop here? It's almost become 1 hour, and tomorrow we'll start.
Stop here, and tomorrow we'll continue.
So we'll start from here. We can mark it so that we can remain tomorrow.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna.